Hello, and thank you for joining us. Monica and I were just discussing the importance of breastfeeding. She's expecting her child in a few months, and we wanted to make sure that she has all of the resources and support she needs to get started right away.
Which I truly appreciate. Getting ready to have my first baby has been a little overwhelming. I was just gonna go with formula because I thought it was easier, but Ms. Lewis here has been explaining to me how easy breastfeeding is. And you were also telling me about some of the benefits breastfeeding will have for me and my baby. I mean, I never knew some of these things.
Many expectant mothers don't, and that's why we're here. I was just explaining to Monica about the benefits that breastfeeding can provide your baby. It lowers the risk of sudden infant death syndrome, also known as SIDS. It also reduces the risk of obesity, asthma, diabetes, and gastrointestinal illnesses in infants.
And you were also saying that it can reduce the risk of high blood pressure and certain cancers later in life.
That's right. And it enhances the development of your baby's brain and immune system. But that's not all. There are also benefits for the mother as well.
Really?
Oh, absolutely. Breastfeeding mothers have a lower risk of developing hypertension, type 2 diabetes, and breast and ovarian cancer. They're also more likely to lose the weight gained from pregnancy.
Wow. Improving my health is great, but I can't believe that I can help my child be healthier even into adulthood by giving them something that's basically free.
And that's not all. Breastfeeding can save you money long after you've stopped. In the U.S., low breastfeeding rates contribute to more than $3 billion in medical costs for mothers and children. But if your child receives the benefits from breastfeeding, that could mean less medications being bought, less time taking off of work to take care of a sick child, and less unexpected trips to the doctor.
You don't have to say another word. I'm convinced. I'm going to be proud to breastfeed my baby and protect him or her from chronic diseases. How long did you say I should breastfeed?
For at least 6 months after the birth of your baby. 6 months is the minimum recommended time to breastfeed your baby to ensure that they receive all of the benefits we've discussed here today.
6 months is nothing at all. Ms. Lewis, the choice to breastfeed seems so simple. Why don't all mothers do it?
6 out of 10 mothers don't breastfeed for as long as they've intended to because they run into issues with lactation or latching on, because they're concerned with medications taken during breastfeeding, or because they don't have the support from family, friends, and even sometimes the hospital where they've given birth. But you don't have to worry about that, okay? There are free breastfeeding resources and support in your area. No mother has to do this alone.